when I realized that something would happen in Hungary. That was not in 89, but that was on the 4th of October 1985. I vividly remember that day because that was the aftermath of the so-called European Cultural Forum. It was a major event at that time. That was an after event of the Helsinki process. Remember, the Helsinki Congress in 1975 agreed that there should be overall European event, including both Eastern and Western politicians and scholars. And in the aftermath of this International Cultural Forum in Budapest, there was a meeting of the editors of major Hungarian newspapers in their party headquarters. And I was sent there as a representative of my boss, Ferenc Lac, who was the editor of a very popular Hungarian historical monthly called Historia. And the senior leader of the party gave a speech about current political issues, and he spoke for about 30 minutes about the meeting of some oppositional intellectuals in a small village not very far from Budapest, and explained that this is a real danger to what they were talking about. There is a real danger to socialism, and the editors should be very careful that they shouldn't publish, at least for the time being, by the people who were present at that meeting. We are sitting in the center of power in Hungary, in the party headquarters, about 30-40 people who are the most influential figures in media. They are sitting there, and we are listening to a report by a senior party leader of 30 Hungarian intellectuals who have no connection to power, who have no influence at all, who are absolutely seemingly insignificant, and they are taken so seriously by a party which has an army, which has a paramilitary force, which has a police force, etc., etc. So if 30 intellectuals as a group can be such a threat, then there is something wrong with the system in Hungary. So that was my first experience when I assumed that something would happen. The next experience was the commemoration of the 30th anniversary of the 1956 revolution the following year, in the fall of 86. And the way it was commemorated seemed to be a warning that there is something wrong again with the political, ideological platform of the party, because they criticized 1956 with such a strength and with so much emphasis that nobody could accept. And so there was such a gap between the official rhetoric of the evaluation of 1956 and the popular evaluation of 1956 that made one thing that perhaps sooner or later changes might happen. As to the very year of 89, there are two events that I can recall. One is when President Bush came to Hungary in the summer of 89. I think it was July 9th, if I properly remember. It was in the immediate aftermath of the death of János Kádár. And it was like in a well-organized Hollywood movie. There was a huge storm in Budapest because he was speaking on a big square in front of the parliament, thunder, lightning, everything, and he tore up his prepared speech, threw away his raincoat and made a very heroic, romantic speech about that he is bringing freedom to Hungary, and then we were waiting for the concrete suggestions. So it showed that something is really in the making. On the other hand, then he announced that the United States would support new environmental policies in Hungary with $5 million. So this is like if I suggest a change in the family and I suggest, well, I have $1 for this for a 5 year or 10 year investment. So it was great hope and disappointment at the same time. The next experience in 1989, that was in early September, because at that time my boss, Ferenc Lotz, was Minister for Culture, and he informed us about, not about everything what he was doing, but his closest associate, and he told us just after the East German refugees were allowed to leave Hungary, he told us how the decision was made about letting the East German refugees go by the government, and he said that some four or five members, most influential members of the government, under the leadership of Miklós Németh, who was at that time the prime minister, were sitting together and were considering what to do about the tens of thousands of East German refugees in Hungary. And then the prime minister said, let us call Prime Minister Ryzhkov, so the Soviet prime minister. And they called Ryzhkov, and Ryzhkov told them that I shall call back. And after a while, Ryzhkov called back and he told them, Vashe Gelo, it's your business, because they were talking Russian. So I think this is very important, because it is frequently forgotten that the Soviet Union was still very strong at that time, and without the consent of the Soviet Union, nothing would have happened. Just the same way as nothing would have happened if the party bureaucracy and the paramilitary forces, so everything that the communist power had at its disposal, wouldn't have been willing to negotiate. So this takes me over to the current perspective. I think now, as this conference also very well shows, there is a universal consensus that 1989 is definitely a turning point in European history, but there is no consensus as to who is responsible for that, so who made it, and there is no consensus about the consequences, so whether the consequences are dominantly positive or the consequences are dominantly negative. I think this is why it is very good that we discuss these very, very differing interpretations, because it's obvious that for the generation that was born after 89, for them this is past history, like for my generation, the period between the two world wars. So they do not have any personal experience. For them, this is only archives and perhaps some survivors report on their experiences in oral history. Now, as far as the Hungarian discussions are concerned, they are very vivid. There is now the most recent interpretation of 1989 is that the real official now interpretation, I would say not mainstream historical, but mainstream political, as on behalf of the present government and the present prime minister, that 89-90 is an important preparatory turning point, but the real turning point came in 2010, when the new government elected at that time made a great effort to really implement changes, whereas during the 20-21 years preceding that, there were only negotiations, discussions, attempts, many of them ending in failure. And this was made possible, according to this interpretation, by the outcome of the elections in 2010 that gave a two-thirds majority to a political force that is now in a position to really change Hungarian politics, Hungarian society. The 16th of June 1989, that is the burial of Imre Nagy. So Imre Nagy was the leader of the 1956 Hungarian Revolution, and the most important turning point, so to say, in 89 was when, at the end of February, a responsible member of the Hungarian Politburo announced that 1956 was not a counter-revolution, but a real popular uprising, a popular revolt. So basically he gave a positive evaluation of 1956, whereas earlier it was either a negative evaluation or a neutral evaluation that was officially given to 1956. And this initiated a process that led to the festive reburial of the executed leaders of the 1956 revolution on the most important public space, so-called Heroes Square in Hungary. So I think the most important symbolic event for Hungarians is this this public funeral, the reburial of the leaders of the revolution, and it was part of this ritual or ceremony at that time, that they read in public the list of all the people who were executed or imprisoned as a result of the 1956 revolution, as a revenge for the